Yeah. अज्ञानतिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो महावदन्याय कृष्णप्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्य नाम्ने गौरत्वे गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकायै तदालये कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तदभक्ताय श्री चैतन्य मनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपा कदा मह्यं ददाति सपदं आददानस्तेनं दन्तैरिदं जाचे पुनः पुनः श्रीमदरूपदं भोजधोगे श्रात्मं जन्मनीयम् Ninth श्लोक we are reading perhaps. Nectar, the nectar of instruction. वैकुंठात् जनितो वरा मधुपुरी तत्रापि रासोत्सवात् वृंदारण्य मुदार पाणि रमणात् तत्रापि गोवर्धन राधाकुंड मिहापि गोकुलमते प्रेमामृता प्लावनात् कुर्जादस्य विराजितो गृह्यते सेवां विवेकेन का read the translation and also half of the purport we have read. You can read the rest purport in Chaitanya Charitamrita.
In Chaitanya Charitamrita, Madhya Lila, it is stated that when Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu first visited the area of Brajabhumi, he could not at first find the location of Radha Kunda. This means that Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was actually searching for the exact location of Radha Kunda. Finally, he found the holy spot, and there was a small pond there. He took his bath in that small pond and told his devotees that the actual Radha Kunda was situated there. Later, the pond was excavated by Lord Chaitanya's devotees, headed first by the six Goswamis, such as Rupa and Raghunath Das. Presently, there is a large lake known as Radha Kunda there. Srila Rupa Goswami has given much stress to Radha Kunda because of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's desire to find it. Who then would give up Radha Kunda and try to reside elsewhere? No person with transcendental intelligence would do so. The importance of Radha Kunda, however, cannot be realized by other Vaishnava sampradayas, nor can persons uninterested in the devotional service of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu understand the spiritual importance and divine nature of Radha Kunda. Thus, Radha Kunda is mainly worshipped by the Gaudiya Vaishnavas, the followers of Lord Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
By reading all these things, anyone can question that why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu glorified this Radha Kund? What is Radha Kund? Merely a lake, not so big, very small, in comparison with sea or any lake, like Caspian Lake, like other lakes in India also, thousand and thousand times more than this lake, Chilka Hrad, Chilka Lake, and so many lakes. Why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is glorifying? Why? If anyone asks, then we may tell that you are Sahajiya. Only by asking. If anyone is discovering all this, searching, where lies this glorification of Radha Kund? By reading this, automatically, naturally, this question will arise. Also, he will see that connecting with Srimati Radhika, Radha Kund has some relation with Srimati Radhika. So what is the glory of Srimati Radhika? And if he wants to know all these things, naturally it will come. So especially he is telling Swamiji that Radha Kund is mainly worshipped by the Gaudiya Vaishnavas, the follower of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Other sampradaya, like Nimbar, like Ramanuj, Madhva, they have nothing to do with this. They don't know all these things about Radha Kunda. So those who are in the family of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they follow Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. They have honor, regard, and everything for Radha Kunda, especially for Radha Kunda, more than Barsana, the birthplace of Srimati Radhika, Rabal, more than Nandgaon, more than Govardhan, more than Vrindavan, anywhere. Why? What is there? What is there? Any beautiful mountain, river, any forest so well decorated, we see nothing there. Then why? A curiosity will come. This Kund is itself, herself, Srimati Radhika. Shyam Kund is also himself, Krishna, embodiment of Supreme Personality of Godhead, that is Brajendanandan Aradhakanta Krishna himself. No difference at all. But more, there are things. Radha and Krishna meets together in Vrindavan, in also Govardhan. They meet there. They play there also Rash. But what is the specialty of this Radha Kunda? Here Krishna is always controlled by Srimati Radhika. And here Srimati Radhika is called Swadhin Bhartrika. But we don't know anything about these things. Then how we can glorify? How you can? How? That is very rare. But if you are not hearing these things, you cannot be qualified in lakhs and lakhs births. So anyone is not so much purified and having so much love and affection that he is qualified to hear. Then what to do? To be hopeless for this forever. Don't be hopeless. Anyone having all kinds of
anarthas,
every kind of, but he has some interest to hear all these things, he is qualified. Even at that time, so much anarths are there. Even if he has honor, he has some great to hear all these things, he must be qualified for this. Only the qualification to hear is that greed. A devotee born in Brahmin family has cultivated his regulative bhakti for lakhs births. He may not be qualified to hear if he has no honor to hear. No, there is ruchi little to hear. He cannot be. But a third class bogus person, like Bilva Mangal, entangled always in lust of any prostitute, but when prostitute sings Radha Ramana Hari Govinda Jai, Radha Ramana Hari Govinda Jai, Govinda Jai Jai Gopal Jai Jai, Gopala Jai Jai Gopal Jai Jai, Radha Ramana Hari Govinda Jai Jai, Radhe 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 Jai 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 Shri Radhe, Radhe 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 Jai 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 Shri Radhe, Radha Ramana Hari Govinda Jai Jai. When this protist used to sing this kirtan, quietly observed, Bilva Mangal used to be attracted and observed. Oh, this is the qualification. Whether he is a lust, wretched person, no qualification, no learned, nothing, but this taste of hearing this thing is qualification of that. Krishna bhakti rasa bhavita mati kriyatam kutopi jadi labhyate tatra laulyam api mulyam ekalam koti janma sukriti. Sukriti, impressed by lakhs and lakhs births, it cannot do anything, it will not help. But if a devotee like Raya Ramananda, Swarup Damodar, Rup Goswami, or their followers are telling the pastimes of Krishna so sweet, their mati, mati means your heart, is always
immersed
in this ocean of love and affection of Srimati Radhika, then it can come easily. It does not require any worldly qualification or anything, even a spiritual quality. It wants only some taste to hear, either from the past impression, life's impression, or newly, no harm. But if it is past, then so strong, and if not, newly impression will give him so much things. So only this is value, to have these things, nothing else. So he is telling that, Swamiji is also explaining that other sampradaya have nothing to do with this Radha Kunda. But why? Radha Kunda is so supermost. Why? Prema Mrita Plavanat. कुर्यादस्य विराजितो गिरिटटे सेवांग विवेकनक प्रेमामृता प्लावनात्। समटाइम्स इन अ रिवर फ्लड कम्स, व्हाई फ्लड कम्स, व्हाट इज द रीजन? Because
torrential rain.
Huh?
Torrential rain, heavy rain.
Too much water.
No.
Snow is melting.
Why?
The river cannot contain so much water, so it overflow everywhere. They just flood.
River is so little, narrow. So small, narrow. And water's heavy water comes.
She could not take.
She could not shake.
Contain.
And yes. Contain. So it has overflowed here and there.
Due to overflow, it is flood.
So here, in Vrindavan, there is a flow, but controlled. Govardhan, more flow, but it can be controlled. But in Radhakund, oh, so much flood.
Overflowing.
Whole Braja, Vrindavan, even Krishna is
flooded by this.
He comes and sometimes playing with waves, going here and there. Srimati Radhika is floating on that float. Both are there controlled only by Premamrita Plavana. Prem is there, Karta.
Supreme.
So by Prem, Krishna is dancing, Radha is dancing, gopis are dancing, all Brajvasis are dancing. Everything, Prem also himself, itself dancing, and to whom it will touch, all will dance. So Premamrita Plavana, Prem is Vrindavan, in Braja, in Gokul. In Gokul, there is plenty of Vatsalya Rasa. In Nandagaon, plenty of Vatsalya, plus Sakya. Sometimes separation mood is there. In Govardhan, all are there, but controlled. But in Vrindavan, here is the lies the glory of Srimati Radhika. In Radha Shyam Kunda, Krishna is not prominent. Who is prominent? Srimati Radhika is prominent. Sometimes Krishna goes there and feeling separation and praying Srimati Radhika, taking three times vati in Radhika, Radha Kunda. Praying Srimati, what? The mantra of Srimati Radhika. Like this being life, Chintan. Krishna, become like a devotee. And praise the mercy of Srimati Radhika. When you will be pleased. When you will be pleased. Agharipurapi jatna tatra divya prasada prasakrita kataksh prapti kamah prakamam ansaradi jada uchyai snan sevanu bandhai tadapi suravdi radha kundam bevas. Rupa and Raghunath are telling that, oh Radha Kunda, you are yourself Srimati Radhika. Only for mercy, to give mercy to the devotees serving here, you are visible like Kunda. So you have much more than Srimati Radhika herself. You are here always like Kunda. Anyone can touch, anyone can take bath, anyone can pray. Krishna himself pray like this. But why all these things? Why Srimati Radhika is always there? Why? There are so many things to know, so many things. There are so many pastimes of this Radha Kunda, Shyam Kunda, that Brahma, Shankar and all wants to be live here, but they cannot live there. You have heard that, Hanuman wants to come in Braja, but he never comes. Why? Can you say? He fears. I may do wrong there. Once Brahma went to Braja to show the glories of, to see the glories of Krishna. But he at once wanted to see his glory by his own effort. And that is why he theft cowherds, boys and
calves.
And thus he made wrong things. So Hanuman is telling that I am Bandar, I am
monkey.
I may do some offenses. If I will see that Yashoda Maiya is having the ears of Krishna twisting, then I may take my gada. And what to do like that? So he fears I should not go to Vrindavan. Otherwise may so many wrong things. So I should not go. That is why general devotees, they don't go there in Radha Kunda. They cannot know the glory of Srimati Radhika. You want to see Radha Kunda? Come with me. Follow me. Yes, so first come to Kusum Sarovar. And from then, Radha Kunda begins. So beautiful. There is in the Radha Kunda, in the midst, in water, there is Swananda Sukhada Kunja. Very beautiful crops. Fragrant flowers are there, peacocks are there, cuckoos are there. And Srimati Radhikar, younger
sister
named
Nanga Manjari,
has decorated it for Radha and Krishna. So beautiful. And on the eighth corner of Radha Kunda is Lalita, Vishakha, Chitra, Champaklata, Tungvidya, Indulekha, Rangadevi, Shudavi. Eight
kunjas.
So beautiful. And after that, thousands and thousands very beautiful groves around Radha Kunda and Shyam Kunda. Also, Roop, Rati, Lavanga, Gunmanjari, Rati Manjari, Gunlali Manjari, Kasturi Manjari, Bilash. There are so many Manjaris, Kunja everywhere. Around Radha Kunda, Shyam Kunda, Dham, Sidham, Vasudham, Sto Krishna, Lavanga, Arjun, and all. Prominent eight Sakhas Kunda. But they have given it to Sakhis. They don't live there. If Krishna wants, sometimes they come, but never come. Very little, rare. And there, Krishna and Srimati Radhika, with her all Sakhis, singing, dancing, doing so many things there. So Radha, Srimati Radhika with her all Sakhis, he used to live there. Pleasing Krishna, serving Krishna, and Krishna, especially Krishna serving to Srimati Radhika. It is called Maha Yoga Peeth. In Vrindavan, Yoga Peeth, where Bansiba, where dance and singing was there, Ras was there. But this is Maha Yoga Peeth, more than that Yoga Peeth. So beautiful all these things, pastimes, always going on. You cannot
imagine
even. So Radha Kunda is so prominent. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came, it was like a small peat having so much water, only like this. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu discovered. He asked that where is Radha Kund and Shyam Kund? The name of that village was
Arid Gaon.
Arid Gaon means Arishtasur Gaon. Arishtasur, Vishabhasur. The Arid Gaon. So this is Arid Gaon means Arid Gaon. But where is Radha Kund and Shyam Kund? He asked from so many old persons. They told that we don't know where is Radha Kund, Shyam Kund, but we know that this is Kalikhet and this is Gaurikhet. Kalikhet means black
pond,
khet,
field.
And Gauri,
white.
Golden
field.
Oh, Kali, Kali means Krishna. Here is Krishna Kund. Not Khet Kund. And this is Radha Kund. They were telling that Gaurikhet, not Gaurikhet, Gaurikunda. And he took bath in that and declared that this is Shyam Kund, this is Radha Kund. Went away from there and discovered Vrindavan Dham. At first, you know that Kameban was called
Vrindavan.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told that here is no Jamuna. It is not nearer to Govardhan. Here is no Kali Harada, no Brahma Harada, Brahma Kunda,
Bansibat,
Kesighat, no. So how it can be Vrindavan? Vallabhacharya came before Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, but he told that Kamyavan is Vrindavan. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu discovered, no. This is Kamyavan and this is
Vrindavan.
And he discovered all the forests, all the places. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. One day, Emperor Akbar, Mohammedan king, he was coming with lakhs and lakhs horses and sanya.
Soldiers,
armies. His horses and elephants were so much thirsty. Himself, he was thirsty. By that way he was passing. He told to anyone that, is there any big pond where we can take water? They told, villagers told, no, there is no so much pond, but you can take water from this. This Kalikhet and
Gaurikhet.
Emperor told that it is not enough for only one horse or any elephant. They can take all water. No harm, you should bring all. And he
came
with all their soldiers and elephants and horses, lakhs and lakhs, horses and so many elephants. They began to drink and water was not dry. All were satisfied with that water, never came down. Emperor was so much impressed and he wanted to make it more deep and all this. But he could not do. So after this, Raghunath Das Goswami came and he wanted to do this. But he was so much worried that this is Chintamani here. Water is Toyam Amritam, nectar. Why I wish like so? So he was repenting. At the same time, a very big businessman, Paisawala, he came there. And he told that Badrinarayan has sent me and he has told me in dream that you should go to Radha Kund and tell Raghunath Das Goswami that I have ordered me to give money for that and you should make it so good. He went to Raghunath Das Goswami and told that, I want to help you in doing this. He refused, I don't want to do these things. But Badrinayan came in his dream and told that you must do. Then he took some money and managed. He did first Radhakund in four corners. Very
square.
Good. Square. Because Srimati Radhika is so sarl, simple. But when he began to do Shyamkund, Krishna is always crooked. Everything of him is crooked. So when he began to make
square.
A square, then there were so many trees here and there. He wanted to cut out. But in the night they were weeping and praying Raghunath Das Goswami, don't cut. We are here doing aradhana of Krishna at the bank of Radhakund. So don't disturb us. Then he told that, oh, Krishna wants to be like crooked himself. So he made it like this. Now, what shape we see, it is made by Raghunath Das, discovered or made by Raghunath Das Goswami. Here once Radha and Krishna were playing. At once, a demon, he took the shape of bull and wanted to kill Krishna, Baladev and all others.
Baladev also there? Baladev Prabhu also there?
No, anywhere else. But Krishna very suddenly took the two feet of
hind leg
and he did like so,
moving around on the sky.
In the sky, and he
threw it,
and he died. Gopis were there. Gopis asked and told Krishna that you cannot touch us, because you have
done Brahmavarta.
Gohatya.
Kill the cow.
You have
killed a cow.
I am not killed a cow, but that was demon. Anyhow, he was in the shape of cow or bull. You have
killed it.
So you cannot touch it. Then how can I touch? Without touch, I cannot live.
How I became pure?
That you should be impure. Pure. How go to Sagar,
all tears
of world, and then take bath and then come. Krishna smiled and called all the tirth there. They came in shape. They were praying and told that what service may we do to you? Become what you should become water in this place. And with his what is this?
Hill.
With hill he gave impression and that became a very big pond. No. Then at once Pashni Praghatam. Vishabhadanuj.
Nasad antaranya thagasti moise visav sattva mapshatang badantam iti chan krishna parsini prakhatam.
Then they became all water and that pond was fulfilled. And Krishna took bath. He told that now I am pure. I can touch you. Never. You are making a pond without your help, and you should take bath there and then you will be pure. So Krishna did it by his health, and they from here, very like this.
Sure.
And it became very big pond, but no water. From where water should come? Krishna told me to take from my pond. And he told all the
Tirthas
that hidden way you should go in this kund, new kund. Gopis refused that we don't want to touch your any water from this kund. We will go to Mansi Ganga in Govardhan and we will bring water from there and we will fulfill. They took lakhs and lakhs pots and began to go, but all the tears
lie down
on the way and all weeping. Srimati Radhike, we want to serve you. Why you are going there? When they were doing so, Srimati Radhika was so
pleased
and he allowed. At once, in the two ponds, a way was there and they entered. Then Krishna took bath and then he touched all gopis. This is the Radha Kund. Here Srimati Radhika is himself Radha Kund and Krishna is Krishna Kund. But supremacy of Radha Kund. Radha Kund, Rupa Goswami has glorified this Kund. Everywhere there is glorification of Radha Kund. If anyone go and touch the water and take achman, or if anyone go and take bath, Swamiji also telling that he will have the mercy of Srimati Radhika to serve Srimati Radhika there. So we cannot tell more glory of Radha Kund than this. But we should try to know what is Radha Kund. More superior than any place in Braja. It has been told that Sin Binda Vipanam Suramyam Api. Vrindavan is so beautiful. Ras is going on there. And Giriraj Govardhan so glorious. But they will cannot be compared to Radha Kund. 1 lakh part, even. Never. Understand what I'm telling you? What?
No comparison.
No comparison.
Even Radha Kund, 1 lakh part can be comparison to Vrindavan and Govardhan.
One little drop. One little
not
drop.
A fraction.
Fraction. So what to tell other tirthas of Braja? So is rare glory of Sri Radha Kunda, very high. So he is telling that if anyone buddhiman,
intelligent,
then he can touch a very little glory of Srimati Radha Kunda. And then he wants to serve Srimati Radhika. If Krishna is ready to give his service, but they will tell nothing. If Radhika mercy is not there, asa bharayam sindh mayai kathanchit kalo mayat gamita klisham patamhi tanchet kripamayi vidhasya sunayvakim me prani prajena varor upakarina. I don't have anything for Krishna. I don't want to live in Radha Kund and Govardhan. Nothing. I don't want to also to serve Krishna. I don't want. If Radhika is not. But if I will hear that Srimati Radhika has gone to Dwarka to serve Krishna, at once I will fly without any invitation, anywhere. And if I know that only Srimati Radhika is in Radha Kund, Krishna is not there, no harm, I will be there. I want to be in Radha Kund, even hearing the chattering and pattering of all villagers. I want to be there. I want to take their eminence and hearing their worldly talkings, gramya katha. But I don't want to go to heaven or anywhere in Vaikuntha or anywhere in Braja, living this place. So this place is so glorious. Then karmibhyah parato hare priya tyaj vyakti jaju gyaninah tebhyo gyan vimukta bhakti paramah premaik nishthastata tebhyasta pasupal pankaj drishastata tebhyo apisaradika prishthat tadyam tadiya sarasi tang nasayet kah kritim. What is the translation?
Number 10. In the Shastra it is said that all types of fruitive workers, he who is advanced in knowledge of the higher values of life, is favored by the Supreme Lord Hari. Out of many such people who are advanced in knowledge, Gyanis, one who is practically liberated by virtue of his knowledge may take to devotional service. He is superior to the others. However, one who has actually attained prema, pure love of Krishna, is superior to him. The gopis are exalted above all the advanced devotees because they are always totally dependent upon Sri Krishna, the transcendental cowherd boy. Among the gopis, Srimati Radharani is the most dear to Krishna. Her kunda, lake, is as profoundly dear to Lord Krishna as this most beloved of the gopis. Who then will not reside at Radha Kunda and in a spiritual body surcharged with ecstatic devotional feelings of Prakriti Bhav, render loving service to the divine couple Sri Sri Radha Govinda, who perform their Astakaliya Leela, their eternal eightfold daily pastimes? Indeed, those who execute devotional service on the banks of Radha Kunda are the most fortunate people in the universe.
I see that so many devotees go to Barsana. So many. And they like it more. They want to go in Gwaharban. Gwaharban, you know? There, Mangad, Dangad, Vilasgad,
More Koti,
all are there. Srimati Radhika playing with Krishna in so many ways there. I think that all the Brajavasi, they think that this Barsana is superior than any place. But they don't know all these mysteries. Never they can. If anyone wants to know the glories of Radha Kunda, they should read Brihad Bhagavatamrita, September 7th, chapter of Brihad Bhagavatamrita first, and also 7th chapter of second volume. Why Radha Kunda is so? Why Krishna has come from Vrindavan and he is living in Dwarka? Why? An ordinary devotee cannot answer all these questions. Those who know the glories of Srimati Radha Prem, they can tell something. Rohini Devi, the mother of Baldev Prabhu, Uddhav, because he was there, and also after that Baldev Prabhu has gone there in Braj, they can tell anything about this Radha Kundan. Braja, why Krishna left Vrindavan, Braja, and he came to Dwarka? There are so many reasons hidden behind. Krishna wanted to satisfy gopis, but he could not there. Napareham nirvadya sanjuja. Why? You know there are two things in prem. Separation mood and
union.
Milan.
Meeting.
Shambho.
When Krishna meets gopis become so happy. And in separation, they become so unhappy. At that time, anyone cannot touch the glory of gopis very high. When Uddha went there, he saw the glory of gopis, like Himalayan mountain, like this. And he became a dust. Krishna sent him to see all these things, realize all these things. Krishna tells in Dwarka to his queen, telling that I want to be in Vrindavan Braja, always in Radha, but I cannot be there. Why? Because the love and affection of gopis are so high that in separation they feel like meeting, and in meeting they feel like
separation.
And it is very, very painful to me. Sometimes Srimati Radhika is sitting in my lap, and Madhumangal came, a bee was hemming there. Srimati was fearing. She told that Madhumangal saw that it is somewhat Srimati Radhika is perplexing.
Perplexed, yes.
So he took a stick and he took that bee very far away. And he returned and told that
Madhusudan.
Driven Madhusudan, he cannot come ever, any time he will not return. And hearing this, she was in the lap of Krishna and she became faint. Oh Krishna, very well. She was in the lap of Krishna, but feeling so separation that he was fainted. Once Krishna was anywhere else, and Srimati Radhika was feeling separation. Krishna saw that in separation, she became so absorbed that he saw a tamal tree and he embraced that tamal tree. Oh, you have returned. And she was laughing, joking to Krishna. Taunting that tree, that as if Krishna was. Sometimes he saw in separation Srimati Radhika was kissing darkness. Oh, this darkness is Krishna. And they wanted to embrace that darkness, that thinking that he is Krishna. Krishna became wonder. What high class of prem is in Radha Kundi, in Srimati Radhika. He cannot satisfy them. Because when he will come to satisfy them, playing with them, but they will think of future
separation.
And they will be always painful. I cannot see all these things. If they will see, they are even more absorbed in separation. So I should not be here. I cannot satisfy them. There, this mood will increase and they will weep bitterly and they will be fainted. Srimati Radhika is telling to her Sakhis, Sakhi, I feel better when I become senseless. And at that time when I am senseless, forgetting all these things. But why you try to make me sense, in sense? At that time I am okay, but when I will return my senses, then again?
Distress.
Why you do so? You are like my enemy. Can you, anyone can imagine these things? So this is the glory of a special of Radha Kunda, where all these modes are there, and Prem is like a overflooded banya.
Flood.
Where Prem Vaichitya is there is Bhramar Gita like. What? Bhramar Gita in 10 parts. What, Kiki?
Talking to the bumblebee.
Chitrajalpa,
Prajalpa, Sujalpa, Dhijalpa,
Anujalpa.
And there are so many things you cannot imagine. So I think that only Vaidhi Bhakti and amalgamated with karma and
gyan,
it will not be sufficient to come in the family of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in his sampradaya. If you are Chaitanya Mahaprabhu sampradaya, you will have to be Rupanuga. What is Rupanuga? Or don't take the name of Rupanuga, otherwise you will be Sahajiya. No. What is the significance of Rupanuga? We'll have to know. Who was Rupa Goswami? What he did? What is his special service? What was his mode? And then anyone can be Rupanuga. Rupag means to serve Srimati Radhika is Rupanuga, nothing else. So this book has given some
hint,
light,
outline.
But any realized soul can explain all these things and he can give impression by this book. Srila Rupa Goswami has made it this, formally this purpose. And that is why Swamiji, he could not write explanation of Shikshastak, Manashiksha, and all other. But he saw that this book is so important. So I should write some explanation. So he wrote explanation of this. But those who will go only, first slok, Bako Vega Manasa, Bako Vega Manasa, Bako Vega Manasa, Bako Vega. And it is all right, and keep it. It is sufficient for us. We are not
qualified
to Bako Vega Manasa. We cannot do. Then how? We have to all see. Swamiji has come to give all these Rupanuga thoughts and lines to us. So we should not be hopeless, we should try to develop our Krishna consciousness in this line. Gaur Prema
Hari Hari.
Yeah.
Krishna, Krishna.